Guys, Robbie here. Today we're going to be talking about the Inbody body fat scanner that we now have available at CrossFit South Bend for you guys to do a body fat scan. So when we did the last video, it was kind of a little bit of a parody, Brandon in boxer shorts getting oiled up by Chad, and we didn't get too much of a chance to talk about the Inbody test itself and what it tells you. So in this video, we're going to talk quite a bit about what the test shows you and how useful it can be. It's a really fantastic test. It shows you so much about your percent body fat, what your ideal weight should be, the amount of skeletal muscle mass that you have, the amount of calories that you should be consuming per day, the amount of muscle in each of your different body segments. So what we're gonna do now is we're actually gonna take a look at an actual in-body scan, and I'm gonna run through it the same way I would with someone who just got theirs done in explaining it to them. So I'm gonna flip this over here real quick so you guys can see. So here we have an in-body scan. I've got the top part flipped down so it's got no identifying information of this person. But basically, we always start off with this area right here, the muscle fat analysis. So in general, being in this dashed area is where you wanna be with these gray boxes. If things are in the down area, that's too low. If things are in the up area, that's a bit too high. So in this case, this particular person who is a female in her 20s, 100% for weight is basically where your weight should be relative to your height. And this person is in kind of the upper area. So, you know, for this particular person to be a bit more healthy, they'd want to work themselves closer to that 100% mark. For skeletal muscle mass, what 100% represents here is that you have enough muscle to support your bones and your joints and your overall body structures. Now, you wouldn't want to be below 100%. That's typically what you would see in like a medical context where people are just, you know, don't have enough muscle and their muscles are atrophying. This person has muscle that's above 100% at 56.7 pounds, which is excellent. So, you know, relative to her weight, you know, a decent amount of muscle, which is good. And then, of course, we see for the body fat mass, this is the total amount of body fat in pounds right here. She's at 72.6, so quite a bit more body fat than muscle. And we have kind of this C shape you see right here where weight juts out, muscle comes back, and then body fat juts out again. What we typically like to see is a D shape, which starts at this 100% mark, goes out for muscle, and then comes back to 100% for body fat. So we'd want to change that C shape to a D shape. Now, if you look down here, you're going to see BMI, which is a measurement that you're probably familiar with for overall health from your doctor. This is a so-so measurement. It only takes into account height and weight. So someone could be a high BMI, but maybe they're just really muscular. So you always have to take into account body fat and muscle when taking into account BMI. But even taking that into account, this person's BMI is a bit too high and it should be closer to this area right here, this gray bar area. Now, probably the most important part of the test here is the percent body fat. So this is gonna be this area right here. And for a female, ideal body fat is between 18 to 28%. Anywhere in there is healthy, with 23% just kind of being smack dab in the middle. For men, 10 to 20% is the healthy range. And this person, you can see 41.7, that's really, really, really high. So to get back into a healthy range, you want to get closer to there for this person. Now, another cool aspect of this test is the segmental lean analysis. So this shows you how much muscle you have in your different body segments, like your trunk and your arm. So this person has, you know, about 6 pounds in their arms and about 15 pounds in their legs. And it shows you the percent of the muscle that you need in those different body parts. So they have about 100% of the muscle that they need in their legs, but about 120% in their arms, which is excellent. You want more muscle. The more muscle, the better. So that's good. So really interesting, shows you any asymmetries. Sometimes it can help you figure out if there's any injury or inflammation in different parts of the body. Now over here, we have the prescriptive element. This is where it tells you what you would need to do to get back to optimal body composition. So this is saying this person needs to lose 42 pounds of body fat. So if you went back over here, It's saying from that 72.6 to get you back smack dab to 100, this person would need to lose 42 pounds of fat, basically taking her down to roughly 30 pounds of body fat. Now, in terms of lean body mass to gain, it's saying 0.0 because she's already passed 100%. So she can gain more muscle and that's beneficial, that's good, but she doesn't need to. So from a health perspective, really what she has to do is lose those 42 pounds. Now, that number that they come up with is really for you to get in this 100% range relative to your height and your age and all these different calculations that they've come up with. And it's pretty good. Generally, you don't need to be exactly at 100%. Being in this gray barred area in general is good, but that's kind of what they're basing it on. Now, the two other things this test shows you that we're gonna focus on, at least in this video, are lean body mass. This is not the same as skeletal muscle mass. This is the amount of muscle you have for your bones and joints and for general movement. This is the amount of all non-fat things in your body. So if you took your weight minus your body fat, you would get lean body mass, but you would not get skeletal muscle mass. So this number is important for two reasons. One, it allows you to calculate this basal metabolic rate, which I'll explain in just a second. But two, it's a pretty good marker. You know, there are different authorities on protein intake and different opinions. But one good general rule that is kind of tossed about that I think is at least a decent starting point is you should be getting 1 gram of protein per pound of lean body mass. So this can really help you dial that in. So this person should be getting roughly 100 grams of protein per day. Now, with the basal metabolic rate, this is the amount of calories this person is consuming, this is the amount of calories that their body is burning on a daily basis, just them being them. Breathing, heart pumping, brain functioning, digestion. It doesn't factor in any exercise. So if this person wanted to lose a bit of weight and they weren't exercising, they would reduce calories by 10 to 20%. If this person wanted to gain more size and muscle, they would add 10 to 20%. Now it's important to factor in that if you're exercising, you wanna up this a bit as well. Lastly, what the Inbody test is gonna tell you is it's gonna show you over time how you progress. So we've got all these different boxes here. It's gonna show you if your weight went up, down, skeletal muscle mass, percent body fat. And this ends up being really important because sometimes we'll see someone's weight stay at the same place, but their muscle mass went up and their percent body fat went down. So whereas a scale won't show you that, the Inbody will. So that's the test, guys, and it's really powerful. It's really amazing. It's a fantastic tool that we now have here at our disposal here at CrossFit South Bend. And if you want to get your body composition honed in and know if you're at a healthy body composition, it's definitely something you should check out. So if you're interested, let us know either via email or let a coach know. It takes 2-3 minutes to do, and then the explanation of the results is maybe 10-15 minutes, so you can get in and out pretty quickly and get all your information. All right, guys, thanks so much for tuning in. We'll see you next time.